conquering king met his death by assassins. Let me say it again. I have a dream. The way our true doctoring king met his death by assassins, who made sure that his civil rights were trampled upon. The way his white meat was exposed when those black tips separated his back skin for your sake. See, history repeats itself. Now, I understand that during Black History Month, there's sometimes a lot of tension, but I ask you, if you please, put your picket signs down and recognize that we're all walking Marcus Garveys with Thurgood faces and Harriet Tubman Drive with Langston Hughes poetic phrases and blood. Blood soaking in our palms for every Mike Brown and Trayvon, and as the bullets fly, they label our cities as being dead. But I tell them to check off pulse rate, we're on life support. Now, do me a favor, turn to your neighbor. No, I'm serious. Turn to your neighbor and tell them that every book has a beginning, and their story can become his story if they allow God to be the author of their fate. See, you'll notice how the Holy Spirit will begin to teach you tongue twisters, twisting Jim Crow laws into civil rights testimonies and slave trade struggles into ownership success stories and lynching mysteries into God-ordained holy matrimonies and our ancestors' agony into history lessons. Check this. Now, the ultrasound of our existence has been echoing to God's ear for all eternity. And what's written on your birth certificate is not your name, but instead it is his favorite song on his playlist, like Mahalia Jackson or B.B. King or Patti LaBelle. See, my people had dreams. See, no one ever thinks about the roots of a tree because they cannot see them. Wait a minute. I want to make sure you guys understand that. No one ever thinks about the roots of a tree because they cannot see them. And Black history seems to be falling like leaves because the next generation seems to be lost in translation. See, but I still have a dream that there exists a Parks to my Rose and a CJ to my Madam Walker. So don't get offended when I ask you, do you have a dream? I mean, my ancestors were brought here on ships with no round-trip ticket. Execution style was their example of violent relationships. So for every whiplash you received, house cleaned, cotton picked, slaves received and deceived, and rape took a hold of her, but yet still, my people had dreams. So I don't care where you come from or what you've been through. Your life is a movie and you've been given a clip. Hold on, I want to see it a little more clear. Your life is a movie, and you've been only been given a clip. So just in case you think that dreaming is overrated, there exists a doorway for you to step outside yourself and recognize that besides crucifixion, civil rights of denial and lynching is the worst unjust committed. We stand on the bloodline of overcomers' rock. So when barbershops are shot up and our people sit locked up,